Hey guys, welcome back to another video. My name is Somil and in this video we will be seeing different common ways to transfer data between components. We will take a look at three different cases. Case 1, transferring data from parent to child via input decorator. Case 2, transferring data from child to parent via output decorator and event emitter. Case 3, transferring data from non-related components or sibling components via services. If you are new to this channel, then don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to never miss out on my videos. I have created two components, child and child 2 component, inside the app component. This results in establishment of parent child architecture with app component being our parent component over here. In our first case, we will be passing data from the parent component to the child component using input decorator. Let's start by importing input decorator from the Angular core in our child component. Then we declare the input decorator along with the property named data, which is of type string. So this means that we expect to receive a string from the parent component. Let's move to the HTML file of the child component. Print the message sent by the parent component in our child component. In the parent component's TS file, we declare the message that we want to pass to the child component. In the HTML file of the parent component, we bind the property in the opening tag of the child component. Here, child expects the property name data, whose value is stored in the message variable. So here we can see that the message has been successfully passed from the parent component to the child component. In our second case, we will be passing data from the child component to the parent component with the help of events. We will pass data from child component when an event is triggered. We will be creating a button. When the button is clicked, the string will be passed to the parent component. Let's start by importing output decorator and event emitter in our child component. We created a property name event of class emitter. To be able to send it to the parent component, we decorate it with the output decorator. I have created a variable named message which is of type string. Let's create a method that will be executed when the button is clicked. We call the emit method of the event emitter to send the message. Next, we create a button in the HTML file. We will bind the click event to the button to call our send message method. In our parent component, we create a method to receive the message. In the HTML file of the parent component, we bind our custom event in the selector of the child component. When the event is received by the parent component, it will call the receiveMessage method. Let's display the message received from the child component using interpolation. As we can see, we have successfully transferred message from child component to the parent component. In our third case, we will be passing data between two unrelated components using services. Here, child and child 2 component are sibling components, or we can say they have no relation between each other. We will be passing data from child component to child 2 component. Let's start by creating a service. We create a service in Angular using ngg s followed by the name of the service. I have created a service name shared and placed it inside a folder of the same name. So basically, how this works is we create methods in the service file which performs certain tasks for the components. Then we call these methods from the component. We create a method called setMessage which will be called by the child component to set a message. We also create a method that will be called by the child component to get the message. In the child, we need to import the service file to be able to use it. Then we inject the service in the constructor. Create a message variable that contains the string that we want to pass to the child 2 component. Then we call the setMessage method from our chat service. Similar to what we had did previously, import the service file and inject it into the constructor in the child2 component as well. To receive the message, call the getMessage method from the service. Create a variable and store the output of the service in that variable. Let's check if we have received the string by printing the message. So here, we have successfully gone through all the three cases. That's it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching.